Financial management is a new topic in Form 4 syllabus. In this video, you will learn to describe effective financial management process. Financial management is a process that involves managing money from sources of income into savings, expenses, protection, and investment. There are 5 steps in financial management process. Setting goals is the first step in financial management process. The financial goal set must be prioritized and specific. For example, an individual would like to have $20,000 of savings in the bank 3 years before marriage. Setting goals can be divided into 2 types, short terms and long terms. Short-term financial goals do not involve a large amount of money, for example, purchasing a laptop, cell phone, and others. Long-term financial goals involve a large amount of money, for example, an individual needs to have savings for retirement, children's education, medical expenses, and others. Setting clear financial goals is the most important aspect in financial planning. Financial goals set based on the SMART concept will help us control our spending in order to achieve the desired financial goals. The 5 key components in this 5 strategy are S, specific, M, measurable, A, attainable, R, realistic, T, time-bound. After setting goals, we will evaluate financial status. Assets and liabilities are the benchmark for evaluating our financial status. Examples for assets are cash, savings, real estate, investments, fixed deposits, unit trust, or company shares. Whereas the examples for liabilities are bank loans, credit card debts, and other financial obligations. After evaluating financial status, now we learn to create financial plan. There are 2 important components in constructing a financial plan, namely the sources of income and expenses. Income consists of active income and passive income. Active income is main income such as salaries, allowance, commissions, and other financial resources. Whereas passive income consists of rents received, interest received, dividends, and other investment. Expenses consist of fixed expenses and variable expenses. Fixed expenses are rent, insurance payments, housing, and car loan installment. Whereas variable expenses are petrol expenses, groceries, electricity bill payment, and so on. After creating financial plan, you are carrying out financial plan. When carrying out a financial plan, we must follow the plan at an early stage. We must be ready to change and compare the planned monthly expenses and actual expenses. This gives us an opportunity to identify any wastage and hence reduce the actual expenses in order to meet the monthly expenses as planned. After carrying out financial plan, we must review and revise the progress. Reviewing and revising the progress of a financial plan from time to time is important to make sure the cash flow is always positive. We should also be prepared to change our financial goals if they are not realistic for our monthly income. Now, let us identify short-term financial goals and long-term financial goals for the list below. The first one, saving for children's education. This is long-term financial goal because it involves a large amount of money and take more than 5 years to achieve. Buy a bungalow. This also long-term financial goals because involve large amount of money. Buy a cell phone. This do not involve a large amount of money. So this is short-term financial goal. Buy a laptop, same as buy a cell phone, a short-term financial goal. Open a restaurant. This involves a lot of money and take time. So this is long-term financial goals. Vacation in Port Dickson. This is short-term financial goal and take maybe less than 1 year to achieve it. Question 2. Madam Wong wants to buy a set sofa which worth 4,000 ringgit. She aims to buy the sofa within 8 months. Madam Wong needs to save 500 ringgit from her monthly income of 3,500 ringgit to achieve her financial goals. Is Madam Wong's financial goal a smart approach? Still remember what is SMART? S stands for specific. Buy a sofa. Stand for measurable. It costs 4,000 and requires a monthly saving of 500 to achieve the goal. A attainable. Can achieve a monthly savings of 500 from the monthly income of 3,500. Realistic. 500 ringgit from monthly income of 3,500 is 14.29% of her income. Time bound. 8 months is enough to raise 400 ringgit with a monthly saving of 500 ringgit. Therefore, Madam Wong applied the SMART concept in her goal setting. Question 3. Encik Hisham received an active income of 3,000 and a passive income of 600 a month. Encik Hisham also incurs fixed expenses of 1,600 a month and variable expenses of 500 a month. Calculate Encik Hisham's monthly cash flow. Explain your answer. Cash flow equals total income minus total expenses. So total income, we have active income 3,000 and passive income 600. So 3,000 plus 600 minus total expenses, fixed expenses 1,600 and variable expenses 500. So 3,600 minus 2,100 equals 1,500 ringgit. A positive cash flow of 1,500 is good as Encik Hisham can invest or deal with emergency situation in future. B. Explain Encik Hisham's cash flow if Encik Hisham's passive income does not exceed and the total expenses also increases by 50%. Cash flow equals total income minus total expenses. Passive income, Encik Hisham only have 3,000 income. Minus total expenses, 150% times 2,100. Equals 3,000 minus 3,150 ringgit. Equals negative 150 ringgit. A negative cash flow will burden Encik Hisham and may cause him to use credit card facilities to solve his financial problems. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, make sure to subscribe for more.